It is an absolute legendary, world-famous fishing destination of Costa Rica. Well, I mean, I'm not in Costa Rica now, I'm at home in New Zealand. But this full feature-length episode right here on ultimatefishing.tv is where me and another Kiwi lad ended up after a string of mishaps having to borrow a boat, borrow some gear, and head out fishing, and between us use our own know-how in an unfamiliar country to have a go at some big tuna and some sailfish. And it turned out to be one of the most incredible fishing days that I've ever had. Sort of doing it Kiwi style on the other side of the world. The weather was beautiful, the fishing was red hot, and a couple of absolutely crazy things happened. I mean, aside from sailfish trying to launch themselves into the boat.
It's about hit you, bro.
We had thousands of tuna frothing all around us.
We're surrounded by yellowfin.
We managed to hook into some.
Yeah, it's a real good one.
I am pumped with that.
But the photo session is kind of when it went a wee bit wrong.
Oh, that hurt. I put a dent in my foot. Oh no, it's broken it. Look, the bone's sticking out.
But don't think for a minute that a broken foot is going to stop me making the most of this incredible day in this incredible destination. We just got on with it, carried on fishing, and in fact, I jumped in the water for an absolutely mind-blowing experience.
I am right in the midst of these yellowfin tuna, and I literally don't know where to point the camera.
So check out all of that action, as well as so much more that happened in this full episode right here at ultimatefishing.tv.
I'm here in Costa Rica to check out one of the great offshore sport fisheries in the world. And you can see right here at the Los Sueños Marina just how much wealth has been attracted by the world-class fishing that's available right outside the marina breakwater. These are some of the world's most elite sport fishing boats, and they're skippered and crewed by some of the best fishers in the business. So naturally, you'd expect to find some Kiwis here. Kieran is a professional crewman, just like I was once upon a time. It can be hard work, but it's an incredible opportunity to travel, learn new fishing skills, and fish aboard some incredible big game fishing boats. We both have a background on big game fishing boats, but we're Kiwis and we like to do things ourselves. So instead of a day out on a multi-million dollar boat, we've borrowed a trailer boat, we've borrowed some tackle, and we're heading out to see what we can catch. And while we're going to be fishing Kiwi style, the variety of fish here is far greater than what we get back home in New Zealand. In particular, the sailfish and blue marlin can be here in huge numbers, with many boats reporting 30 blue marlin releases in a single day. And the yellowfin tuna can be found here in huge shoals frothing on the surface, and I'm frothing myself at the prospect of finding some yellowfin tuna today. But first we're gonna set out some of the baits that we've pre-rigged and troll for a while we get familiar with this boat and this gear and prepare for a big day offshore in Costa Rica, fishing Kiwi style.
We are fishing. There you go.
Oh, there he is.
See,
oh, I jumped him off.
Yeah.
Jumped him off.
Bugger.
There's fish here, y'all.
Yew.
Oh, we just got here.
We got bit.
Just got the boat. We haven't even got a teaser in, have we?
Nah.
We haven't even got a teaser in. Just a couple of little wiggly ballyhoos out. There you go. You don't need all that stuff in the water. There'll be fish here. Look at this snap swivel. Game fishing, mate. Big game fishing. I wouldn't even use that for snapper. Wobbles through the water like that. Sinker at the front, just keeps it just below the surface. And that circle hook right at the front. We're trying to feed him, tighten up, get the sailfish right in the corner of the mouth.
Yeah, snap the back a little bit, give them a little bit of morning yoga, and then test that they're gonna swim.
So we've got just a couple of the ballyhoos that we're running out for the sailfish. But while we're doing this, even though we've only got one teaser, that is one marlin lure with no hook in it, we could raise a marlin on it. So we've got this guy ready to pitch out. Mackerel bait, pre-rig ready to go. That's just gonna sit in the cooler. And if we spot something behind that teaser and it's not a sailfish, in fact it's a blue marlin, this goes out and then, well, I'd say we're ready for anything, but should never say that. Oh yeah, it's probably about, oh, kink there, eh?
Get rid of that.
It's the thing, we're just checking this line, like, all this gear's been borrowed. We've thrown it.
There we are, butt again. Beat him.
We're on the button and we're tight. And we've dropped him.
Yep, on that right flat, sailfish. Back in the freeze pool.
Back in the freeze pool.
Oh, he's on you.
Yeah, I just got picked up on this one. There he is, Ryan. Yeah, I'm tight on this one, man.
Right, he's eating it. There he goes.
Yahoo!
Oh, right, not so bad for a couple of learners, mate. Not bad for a couple of learners.
You get another bait on that one, Matt, and we'll just do a little circle around him.
Yep.
We'll just do one. We're just pulling a circle around this fish because these sailfish, they're in packs. So we're trying to hook another one for Matt so we can catch them two at a time.
I'm just changing up my bait. The sailfish is eating that bait. Kieran's doing the circle. And we're going to see if we can hook another one. Why not, eh? I won't bother checking it out, just get it straight out.
Yeah, just get it nice and short there.
Yeah.
When you can, chuck those on.
Yeah, okay. So there's just the two of us, and while we're getting to know this borrowed boat and the borrowed gear, we're also driving, crewing, filming, I don't know, I'm talking, doing TV stuff as well. Multitasking. That's awesome.
Yee-hoo!
Right there, Dan. Right.
Punch in,
he's gonna go nuts.
Alright, we'll get wind that one in there, Matt. Get a release. Wind that one in, we'll get a release on that.
Okay. First time on the helm with this thing, just so I get the feel for it.
That's a double there. Release. So as we fish over here. That's a release.
Oh, really?
Leaders come through the rod tip. Yep.
Okay, I'm neutral now, bro.
But we're gonna cut him off. Nice and short.
Woo-hoo. That's a release. Hard and fast, there was no time to practice. I was literally like, okay, what are these presets on this drag? How does this boat drive? Too late, boom, we got a sailfish on and we got him.
Awesome, good stuff.
First That's a good morning. Start, thank you, mate.
It's
beginner's luck, eh? Oh, there's one beginner here.
Cool.
That is a good start. That is a mean start. That is hard and fast, right? Shut down these osmos. Right, I was in the process of sorting out this bloody kink in this line, wasn't I? And that all that shit went out. So, as you can see, it's just myself and Kieran out here today, and I tell you what, I've fallen on my feet, not only finding a good Kiwi boy to drink beers with, but one that knows his stuff. He's been crewing here for a while. We've got the connections through Kieran to borrow a boat, borrow a whole bunch of gear, and we're out here with the game fishing fleet of Costa Rica, seeing if we can do it Kiwi trailer boat style. So first off, it's just checking all the line on this borrowed gear, getting stuff rigged up, and we're gonna see what we can catch. Feels good to be doing it ourselves. DIY, Kiwi style.
We'll make it work.
It's taking me back to my crewing days. Trying to keep up with this guy over here. Sure. Okay, the old bimini twist. So it is a very efficient knot to create a double, provide a shock absorber, and attach a wind-on leader. Now I'm doing this pretty quick because we've got some fish here, but you can see a step-by-step on how to do this knot. All for free at ultimatefishing.tv. So now, while we're trolling, we're not trolling lures with J-hooks. So essentially we're not trying to really snag the fish as it bites. We've just got that circle hook at the front of our baits. So these reels are completely in free spool. They're held by a clip. So when the sailfish or marlin comes up, grabs at our bait, it pops out of the clip and we're free spooling it back, we're feeding it. And it's about then getting that timing right so it's got the bait in its mouth, but not too deep, tightening up and getting that hook to roll corner of the mouth. And we'll see if we can execute it. Is that a bite?
Yeah.
We're bit.
Yeah, it's sailfish.
Multitasking, bro. Okay, I'm just gonna leave this in pre-spool for a second. You're driving all right? You're good?
Oh, yeah.
Keys are clear.
No, just...
Yeah, space all clear.
All right, tight one there. A little bit going on in that turn.
Yeah,
but
a little bit going on, all right.
Beauty of a circle hook, you can get caught out and it's already pinned right there in the corner of the mouth, so you ain't coming off. Settle back in here and keep driving our turn.
Okay, I'll grab a release knife.
Double right here. Release. No, right here.
Woo! Oh, in shit, man! Just about jumped, fucking, it's about hit you, bro. Bully him
up.
Okay, I got him here, mate. Oh, look, he's got a few marks on him from where he hit the boat.
He'll survive, though.
Yeah, mate, he'll be all good. It was Dan I was worried about. Dan was looking for him jumping out here, and he's all, almost got you.
Look at that hook.
You need a wide angle lens on there.
Wiping back my head.
I reckon I'll get that hook out piece of piss. What do you
reckon? If you want to. Yeah. Or just cut it right short. I mean, they're a high carbon hook, eh?
Okay. So that's part of what you do here, high carbon hooks.
All the high carbon.
And they all fizz out real quick. Because you can quite often cause more damage to the fish trying to take the hook out, particularly a circle hook. This guy, right now, is going home. We're going to be right down here, though, the way he goes. Nice! There we go, trailer boat fishing. I was going to say just like home, but this is so different. This is so different from what we do at home, man.
The only thing the same, there's a bunch of kiwis.
Yeah, it's the only thing the same. Is that there's kiwis, mate. And that is it. All right, okay, teaser rod back in place. Let's do it again.
Just come back through where we had those couple bites there. So you see, like, you know, you got the short bite and then in all likelihood it was the same fish that ate me long there, so.
Well, we're fishing. Far out, this is awesome.
Cool, eh?
It is, mate. It's like, because I'm learning so much, you know, like, it's just a lot of these things, skills I can take back home, just little things, little tweaks to your fishing. And that's the beauty of fishing around the world with different people. And I tell you what, in this part of the world, kiwis, particularly there's a sailfish over there, bro, sailing on top.
Yeah, on that flat, sailfish from something. Feed him.
Okay, we're on the button and we're tight. And we dropped him.
Back in the free spool.
Back in the free spool. Yeah. Yeah, got him on. There he is.
Yeah. Yoo.
No gimbal belt required. Beautiful. It's like awesome. There he is. There he is.
Here
he comes.
We'll get rid of this one.
Beautiful.
Corey Hertz himself. Nice work, man.
Mate.
Awesome.
Oh, good. Oh, yeah, well, there's one and a half of us that knows what they're doing here. Okay, that fish has been released. Got another bait. Kieran's already swum it up, so we know it swims good. And we're back out fishing. This one's going up the rigger. Here we go. One less bit of plastic in the ocean. And there goes the plastic bottle challenge. I'm throwing it out to all boaties. We're right in the middle of a hot sailfish bite. Still got time to stop and do our little bit. Make sure none of your rubbish goes in the water either. Oh, there goes. Look at that.
Right.
Right, we'll grab that and then we're back to fishing.
Yeah,
then we're going fishing. We've done our bit. Oh, look at this. I caught a fish. He's been gill netted. You can see this thing's got crabs all over it. And this little guy has got himself jammed in there. Little puffer fish thing. Freedom! Wow, that's crazy. Something like that. Not only is it the plastic that breaks down in the ocean, you can see there, a little fish got itself stuck in there. Man, oh, good deed for the day. Tangaroa shall reward us. Just softening the backbone, little clicks, like a good osteopath. Just freeing up the spine to get maximum suppleness and swimmability. So he's swimming on his side, this one a little bit. Yeah, there you go. You can see the little bit of beak and the copper's twisted there. I just got to straighten it up. And this guy is swimming beautiful now.
Oh yeah.
And we're tight. Okay, we got one on, just looping around him now. I'll get that teaser for you. We're almost looking like a professional crew this time. Kieran, almost.
Almost, get in there.
Almost, mate. We'll get that double on and catch it, and we'd almost claim it as being pro. Okay, so Kieran's fighting the fish, we're getting gloved up, driving the boat. Still got a bait out, we've got a sailfish jumping here. And we're starting to get the hang of this.
Ew!
Little wriggly little rats, aren't they?
Yeah. It's all about the process that makes it fun,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, it is.
Ew!
Pulled them off.
Did you?
Nah.
No.
Yep.
Nah,
we're good.
You got him.
Man, it went slack.
There he is, look at that, beautiful man. Okay, little guy. That was cool, bro. There we go. And we let him go. Boom.
That's like that.
Almost professional.
Almost
professional.
That, four for six now.
Oh, he's got bit. There you go. So we're on a patch of fish here. We've got bait fish, we've got dolphins, and we've got like a fleet of sport fishing boats. These guys here are hooked up to a double. They've got fish jumping. We've just released our fourth from six bites. It's pretty good. Something to look at everywhere you look. Bait. I'm all about bait. I've got no idea what the local bait variety is, but whatever it is what the fish are eating. So we're gonna try and catch it and see if we can convert them. Well, we've marked bait. So 120 feet, what's that, 40 meters. Yes, bait. I'm more excited about this than I have been about those sailfish. Well, I love catching bait. I'm a bait man at heart. Come on, in the boat, little babies. Here we go. Yeah, what are these guys? It's like a cross between a pilchard and a mackerel.
Slimy.
Yeah. Beautiful looking bait. I think this is what they call Gorgalax, but I could be wrong. Here we go. Oh, I had the full string, I lost one.
What do you reckon?
Yeah, mate, that's us, let's do it. We've caught sailfish, we've caught bait. Time to sort of boost to the, out to the horizon, out into the open ocean, across the edge of the shelf, and look for some tuna. Some yellowfin tuna. Right, so one of these live eds goes on. So we've got live bait out just in the water while we're getting the gear ready, changing from sailfish mode into tuna mode. And we've got spinner dolphins here. And in this part of the world, when there's spinner dolphins, there's usually yellowfin tuna, they run together. Okay, so we're in front of the spinner dolphins and we're throwing out this squid, just with a single hook in it. But what's interesting about the way we fish this, as you can see that squid there, so I'm only just letting that squid touch the water for a second because the tuna have got incredibly good eyesight and they get fished pretty hard in this part of the world. So they've wised up to a lot of techniques. So we just got to not give them a chance to see that it's in fact an artificial lure. And as we know, yellowfin can leap out of the water to take a bite. And if something eats that right there, it's exciting.
Oh, he got it. Oh no, missed it, he missed it.
It's there in the water. I'm just pumping the rod to keep that leaping out of the water. Maybe you can go a tiny bit faster, mate.
Come on, come back, buddy. Oh, come on, eat it.
Okay, just go neutral here, bro.
Yeah, that's tuna right there. Yeah, that's tuna, all tuna right here.
Yeah, it is too. Now my bait is in the zone. Oh, look, you can see them. Ten yellowfins, bro. Get that dipping, bro, get that dipping. Oh, yellowfin, this is all yellowfin tuna. You're rolling on that, eh, Dan? All yellowfins, come on, eat some bait. They're swimming past my bait now. Oh, that was a good one. There was a good one out the back here.
Come on, eat this.
It had to have been at least 40 kilo one there just rolled right next to my bait. Yeah, I've just been bit, bro, it's been bit. Got him on. Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy, one of them finally ate. I'm still tight. Yeah, boy, we're tight. We're bending on a yellowfin. Yeah! Roll that shit, boys. Oh, man, I thought we weren't going to get a bite. There was just so many yellowfin. I can see them feeding out here, too. It is all going hot around us. Yellowfins. Yes. Not bad for a couple of learners, eh, Kieran?
Yeah, not bad, mate.
Holy shit, look in front of us. Oh, imagine casting into this. Yellowfins! That is yellowfin tuna. And yellowfins out the back of us. And
Dana,
out the back of us.
Here, Dana.
Holy
good.
Shit, we're jolly surrounded by yellowfin. That is all yellowfin. Roll everything. That is all yellowfin out there. Those ones are frothing more. Boom, those ones down. There's more of them there, I think. Well, they're tighter anyway. That is yellowfin frothing. Look how close they are. Meanwhile, we're fighting one, so I shouldn't get too excited about worrying about all the other 2,000 around us. Holy yeah, they've come up and they're playing ball. Oh man, Christmas time. Yeah, pulling hard. Pulling like, look at all the scales in the water.
Yeah.
The scales in the water from the bait being annihilated by those yellowfin. I don't know how many there were, but there wasn't hundreds, there was 1,000. Soon feel the burn in this heat, I tell you. It's a good burn. Oh, I've got some drag on, bro. Oh.
Okay.
Yeah.
Man, that was sick.
I know, we were right in the middle of it. Oh, far out, it wants to fight. Sweet, oh yeah, there is, not that far away. His head's coming towards us at the moment, eh?
Yeah, I'm just a bit stuck on this, eh?
There he is. It's not a rat, eh?
It's a good one.
Yeah, it's a real good one. It's a real good one, bro. Shit, yeah, that's a nice fish, bro. Look at the colours on that thing, would you? There he is.
Oh. quiet. I don't want to take a rash one.
Yeah, let me roll. Let me roll. Over the top, mate. There you go. Come on. Yep. You got him. That's a big one, boy. That's a big one.
I took my time, but
got him in the eye. That's a big one. If we don't catch another fish on this trip, I am pumped with that. That's like your 100 pounder, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Easy. Holy. They talk about 60 pound being a big one here. That is kiwi boys. Kiwi boys. I can't believe it. Well, when we were rigging up gear this morning, getting this boat set up, I thought, well, let's just go out and give it a hack. I was not expecting to be standing here on the deck staring at an amazing fish like that. I haven't caught a yellowfin like that in a long time. You got him. So, like myself, Kieran's done a little bit of work on commercial boats, and this bit of monofilament is going to be fed down inside the tuna's backbone. Now, you can see him spasming. He's dead. Now, you watch these finlets. At the moment, they're all twitching, right? Everything's alive. This bit of mono going in here is going down inside the spine and it's severing his nerves. And you can see up here, no twitching, down here twitching. As the line gets down, it's cutting off all the nerves. It makes all the meat relax. And this is how you get your premium grade sashimi.
I think we're there, so let's see, see how deep I got.
The bit of line there has been right up inside the core of the tuna's spine, severed all its nerves. Notice there's no twitching now. Now, all the nerves have been cut off. That flesh will be relaxing because the tuna, even half an hour after it's dead, the nerves can be still firing out from the backbone, tensing that meat and making the meat tough. And the other thing is it starts cooking. Now, that's because the tuna are endothermic. That means they've got the ability to warm their blood to above the temperature of the water. Now, the water's almost 30 degrees. So if they're heating their blood above that, they can really start to cook. So the first thing we do, sever all those nerves from the spine. Now we're just bleeding them out. We've nicked the gills, taking that blood out, which has got all the heat in it. Now we're gonna pack this thing on ice and it is gonna be premium grade sashimi. Because taking a beautiful fish like this, you've got to treat it with the utmost respect. Kia ora tangaroa. Or Poseidon, whoever's out in these ways. Okay, let's get him up on the lap. Yeah, that's 100 pound all day. Now, just while I got him here, I've got to run through the anatomy. Now, they are the perfect form for speed and power. Now, believe it or not, long and skinny isn't as efficient for short bursts of speed. They need this bulk that in fact provides all the muscle to power them, but it's also very hydrodynamic. Their mouth closes and they become a bullet. The fins here, you'll see this line, that fin perfectly recesses in there. So there is absolutely no drag. Even their scales and the film of slime that they have helps them slip through the water. Now these little finlets, each of these little yellow finlets turns individually. Now the reason they turn individually is when they put on so much power, they're traveling through the water so fast that if this tail cavitates, they would actually spin out of control. So these are making minute adjustments to keep the same amount of water pressure either side of that tail that's beating very fast. Now, it's not a very big tail, and that's like having a small prop on your boat, higher revving. So it's low volume, high velocity tail that really powers these things through the water. We saw them crashing everywhere, and now I've got one of these beautiful things in my arms. What's the jam here? We
drop them there, man.
Rip this shit out.
Get him in this
fin. Oh, that hurt. Put a dent in my foot. Oh no, it's broken it. Look, the bone's sticking out. Damn, something's sticking out, eh? Mm-hmm, that's not good. Damn it. Better get a bit of ice straight on it, eh? It's broken. Damn, broken my foot. That's a real buzzkill.
Super sore.
Yeah. Yeah, like you can kind of see the bone poking up there.
Yeah.
Sorry, mate, I'm gonna shoot this.
Yeah. From the high highs, I'm not even gonna say low lows.
Like, I know it's going to kick in that it's a real bummer that I've broken my foot. But at the moment, I'm still buzzing with that fish. Just hurts, like, a lot. A lot.
Yee-hoo-hoo! That's a big one, boy! If we don't catch another fish on this trip, I am pumped with that! Kiwi boys!
Oh, that hurt. Put a dent in my foot. Oh no, it's broken. It look, the bone's sticking out. Damn.
Just hurts like a lot. A lot.
Right, so just gonna head and gut this tuna here. I'm gonna start just by cutting around the anus here, by cutting this gill membrane all the way forward there, just like that. Cut through the throat latch here. Do the same on the other side.
There you go, not a bit of meat wasted.
Oh yeah, give us that, bro.
You'd eat that.
Yeah, yeah, mate. That'll help my foot.
Found.
Always eat the heart of the first tuna you catch. It gives you the mojo of the sea, the strength of the sea, and right now I need it because my foot's real sore. And besides that, it's actually delicious. And coming right up, more yellowfin tuna action right after the break. I don't even know if it's time for a break, but we gotta get that camera to turn off so I can swear about how sore my foot is.
Oh, look at that. Beautiful.
I mean, aside from the awesome fish that we've caught and seen today, and the things that fishing has allowed me to do, I've come to the other side of the world, I've seen just incredible sights since I've been here, and here I am now, celebrating a massive yellowfin tuna, drinking an icy cold coconut. Thank you, fishing, for the opportunities, for moments like this.
Well, I'm gonna wash the blood off this shirt, mate. Don't get a bite.
Yeah, we're back. There you go, but again. Bail again.
Yeah. Well, I dropped it back a little bit, then he ate it. Yeah, got him on. There he is. Woo! Yeah, then I've got my painkiller, so we'll just go. The ridiculousness of this. Look, I'm just trying to have my Panadols. The foot isn't feeling all that flash at the moment. Painkiller's here. But this catching a sailfish is definitely helping, I've got to say. Now not only do I have to fight a sailfish with a very sore foot I can't put any weight on, but because I took my shirt off to clean it, I now have got to flex the whole time just to try and hide my dead body flab. It's tough, mate, it's tough. My right arm stand is way bigger. My right arm, my right bicep is way bigger than, honestly. But anyway, film the selfish junk.
There he goes, coming at us. Coming at us.
He's right over on this side. Crazy bastard.
Holy shit.
You alright?
Yeah, bro. Oh, getting beaten up, man.
Sailfish beating you up.
Yeah, I know. What's going on? Look at that. Just hold him there for a second. See if we can get a pole here, mate. Oh, no. Let's just let him go there. That's perfect. Yeah.
Try it before he hurts the rest of us.
Oh, yeah. That was rad.
Holy shit.
Holy crap.
Damn, we wouldn't have had anything forward there.
You know what? My foot doesn't hurt at all now. The adrenaline, mate. The adrenaline. Oh, that just about jumped in the boat three times. Holy. It jumped right over the bow. It hit that rod, bro. He didn't break it.
He was a psycho. That one was rolling and the one in the rigger was rolling. Sailfish beating you up.
We've spotted more tuna leaping out of the water in front of us. We've got the birds. Oh, there goes the tunas. Tuna are leaping right out of the water, like three meters in the air, like, oh, there they go. Yes. and the idea is to get up in front of them, in front of the dolphins, because they're moving so fast, drop the squid in the water and see if we can get one to make the mistake of thinking it's real. Oh yeah, birds are dipping here, birds are dipping right here. We just about run over the top of some. There's some big ones there too, bro, right in front of us. Oh yes! That was like 20 feet in the air. See the bait, look at the bait.
Bro, the tuna, did you see it? As it jumped, it like bunted the bait up into the air and that bird caught it mid-air. Like Edinburgh shit, bro.
Boost in there, bro, and we'll just get a look. There they are, they're chasing the bait that way. Oh, crashing everywhere.
They're all around us.
Crashing everywhere.
Maybe now's when we push the bait.
Chuck a bait into those, eh?
Yeah.
Okay, in neutral.
See the bait, look at the bait.
Look at the bait fish there smoking. Oh, yes. Punch in on that, then they're gonna keep jumping right there. What do you reckon we go over into them over there, eh?
Yeah.
See the bait, look at the bait.
Look at the bait fish there smoking. Oh, yes.
Testing 1, 2. I'm about to go in, see what we can see under there. Test my foot in a, and by putting it into a fin and trying to swim.
Test the Panadol, more like it.
Don't swim my body, I told you. I don't have abs anymore. Yeah. Swollen account, but.
So I've got a broken foot and I'm in my undies, but I'm pretty hyped up with this golden opportunity to see if I can get a rare underwater glimpse at yellowfin tuna and spinner dolphins feeding out here in the open ocean.
They're right here, coming at ya. I should put a light bait out, eh?
I can make out some shapes down deep. They could be tuna, so I take a dive to try and get a closer look. It's tuna, big yellowfin tuna, and even more of them than we saw from the surface. And now they're right under the boat. Kieran has a live bait out, and surely he's going to hook up.
Hopefully he's gonna eat this bait. Freaking out.
Right under us, hundreds of yellowfin. Right down here now, hundreds of them. Lots of yellowfin, man. Like lots. And I didn't see any little ones, eh? They were all like 20 kilo or bigger.
Yeah.
So I've got a nice shot of a big one too, I think.
So that one was on then.
What's that? Yeah, bro. Yeah. Like it was just they were about 10 or 15 meters down. I went right down to them.
Yeah.
In fact, I think I filmed one above me. Let's go do that again. Holy shit! Yeah! I thought they were all dolphins. I looked down and I thought, oh, the dolphins are coming under me.
Yeah.
And then I just saw the yellow.
I'm still trying to catch one though. Yeah. It's been a rod hog all day.
That's the kiwi. Oh, today, I couldn't even feel my foot at all then.
They're all around us and good ones. Go. They're right here. Coming at ya. Yeah, that looked like a tuna right there. Yeah, right there, look, he's in the middle of them right now.
I am right in the midst of these yellowfin tuna.
Yeah.
And I literally don't know where to point the camera.
Look at that, everywhere.
Everywhere I look, it seems like there's more tuna just appearing out of the blue and swimming in all directions.
Oh yeah, right here.
Fuck, bro. Did you not get a bite? Oh, fuck, you make it, you see the footage.
Look at that, everywhere.
Go again.
Ah.
You do bonitos and, oh, no, nah. You just need to see the footage. I could have touched some of them.
Yeah.
I could have just about touched them. I was getting swarmed, bro. Right. Gotta do that again.
Yeah.
I got them eating off the surface too.
Yeah, they were like all around here. Like, awesome.
Man. You get footage of them rowing?
Yeah.
Oh, on
my foot, man.
It is.
Yeah. This gave me a reminder, it is pretty bad, eh?
Damn it. We got 10
forgotten
more
all about it then.
One more shot.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Make my foot feel better again if I get on.
Jumping. Look, I'm
outie. Yeah, go. Neutral.
Right now, the adrenaline has completely masked the pain in my foot. And how could I pass up the opportunity to be in the water with yellowfin tuna? And so many of them, the tuna go down as far as I can see, and they've been streaming past me for hundreds of metres. There must be thousands of them here. I've always wanted to do this, and I thought I may never get the chance. So I'm just thrilled to be seeing this. When I started game fishing in New Zealand in the late 90s, the yellowfin tuna were just as plentiful as this up and down the coast of New Zealand. But these great shoals of ocean predators were decimated in purse seine nets, and they've never fully recovered. But here in Central America, they see the value in preserving these fish and restricting purse seining. And look at the results. The shoal has been swimming past me for 2 minutes, and they're still coming.
They're right under me now. Yeah. There's the tuna.
Some of the tuna swarm in to take a look at me before carrying on in pursuit of the bait fish that they drive to the surface where they can then feed on them.
Yeah, right there, look.
He is in there.
I'm here watching from below as some of the yellowfin peel off and attack the bait fish on the surface before rejoining the flow of tuna that are relentlessly in pursuit of more food. Because yellowfin tuna are constantly moving and their body temperature is warmer than the surrounding water, they need lots of energy, and that means lots of food. And that's just to maintain their size. But because they grow fast, they need even more food. A 60 or 70 kg yellowfin tuna is just 4 years old. And here's one here that's around that 70 kg mark. And he's heading straight for Kieran's bait.
Saw the biggest one that year, that night.
So.
It was right at the back of the schoolie's last one. He got to here and he just hung a hard right and boosted straight to the boat. Like he tends the bait.
Yeah. He was freaking out with bait.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Got the footage, boy.
That was mean. That's like probably one of the last experiences for me that I like swum with the North, Big North Atlantics, the Southerns, and the North Pacifics.
Yeah.
All in New Zealand, never swum with the yellowfins, not in numbers like that. Worth breaking your foot for, some would say.
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.